It's time for the whole nine yards. Hello again, everyone. I'm Ralph Fentry. I have the whole nine yards on NEC football just for you. It's week 12, and it all comes down to this. One last chance to lace them up and lay it on the line. Sacred Heart sits alone in first place at 5-1. Three teams are tied for second place. All eight NEC teams are in action this week. Now, as for the postseason, Sacred Heart and Bryant are still alive for the NEC's automatic bid to the FCS playoffs, and it's Sacred Heart with the inside track on that race. I'll tell you more about that as we hit the opening drive. So let's get to work. Let's run through our four Week 12 matchups in our opening drive. We start with Duquesne at Wagner. A lot of seniors who want to go out on a winning note amongst the Wagner veterans who hope to will the team to victory Saturday on Grimes Hill. Well, those are the defensive stalwarts, Titus Leo and Ahmad Lyons. Ahmad Lyons, a versatile defensive back, unselfish as well. The team needed him to move to cornerback during the season, and he did so, performed admirably at the cornerback position. Then up front, there's defensive end Titus Leo. Leo won the NEC Defensive Player of the Year award last spring as a linebacker. This year, he's been sensational as a down lineman rushing off the edge. He has made multiple tackles in every game this year, and his 18 and a half tackles for loss rank fifth overall amongst D1 FCS leaders. Now, Lyons at cornerback will likely have to match up with either Duke's veteran receiver Cyrus Holder or Davey Henderson. Both Holder and Henderson had impactful performances in last week's win over Central Connecticut. Duquesne has plenty of veteran talent worthy of all-conference consideration on both sides of the ball. And on defense, that list starts with senior safety Leandro DeBrito. The senior has made 51 stops over nine games this season, and he'll be ready to wear the Duke's uniform one more time in an attempt to get one more win.
Staying together, man. We just came together, and it's always a tough game when we play Dan, man. This is beautiful, man. This is how we worked for, and we got it. Great, man. It was one of the best things that ever happened to me coming to the school. They helped me a lot.
It'll be DeBrito and the Dukes invading Staten Island for the finale, and Duquesne head coach Jerry Schmidt is confident his team can meet the challenge.
Great place to play up there, and it's always a tough game because they're always a big physical team. They've hit some bumps here in the road, through this season, playing some bigger schools and got some injuries, and so it's always a concern. They're playing some teams really tight and just had some bad breaks, and we just want to make sure those breaks don't start coming against the Dukes.
Moving on to St. Francis at Central Connecticut State. St. Francis, which has clinched a winning conference record this fall after sitting out last spring, will they enter at 5-5 overall, looking for win number 6 on the season? On the other side, Central Connecticut needs a victory to post a winning NEC record once again. The Blue Devils have finished above 500 in conference play in each of the last 3 seasons. This could be number 4 in a row. Now, CCSU has upped its offensive output of late. The Blue Devils have scored at least 27 points in each of the last 3 outings. Meanwhile, the Red Flash defense has been stout. The Red Flash have allowed no more than 18 points in any of the past six games. St. Francis head coach Chris Valerio has been impressed by his defense, to say the least.
They're playing at a very high level. You know, Scott Lewis and his staff are doing a tremendous job of getting these guys ready week in and week out. And, the guys are answering the bell. They're playing hard. They're playing physical. I think our effort has been great all year.
With both sides seemingly evenly matched come Saturday on a Root Field, a special teams play or two could make the difference between winning and losing. And thus far this season, special teams have been a strong suit for St. Francis.
So our special teams has really, really stepped it up this year. And it's just been really fun to watch, because when you have that kind of energy going in, it can flip the game real quick. We have a punter that's been punting it well. So, all in all, our special teams this year has really taken a step forward. And it's just been, as a coach, it's a pleasure to watch, because, again, it sets a lot of the times your special teams will set the tone for the game.
Shifting the scene to North Andover, Massachusetts, where it's Bryant at Merrimack. We'll start with the visitors, as Bryant wrapped up a perfect home record last week, 4-0 at Burns Stadium in Smithfield. Now they hit the road aiming for a 7-win season and a possible share of the NEC title if other results go their way.
This football team is a good football team. Today they played kind of ticked off, knowing that we lost an opportunity last week. But right now we're still playing for a 7-win season. We're still playing. Anything can happen in the NEC. Who knows? We just got through telling them, I don't care what the other scores are. God will take care of the rest. We're going to go next week and try to put a 7-win cap on the season.
Now, a deeper look at this matchup shows two teams who ushered in new starting quarterbacks this fall, and both teams have posted impressive victories because of their signal caller. For Merrimack, graduate transfer Weston Elliott has looked right at home in North Andover. He has had a bevy of reliable targets on the field, and his numbers speak for themselves. Elliott leads the Northeast Conference in completion percentage, pass yards, and passing touchdowns. Elliott's 30 TD passes are an NEC single season record. As for Bryant, true freshman quarterback Zevi Eckhaus, well, he's been starting since week two. Eckhaus has thrown at least two TD passes in seven straight games. Last time out, he threw for a conference high 356 yards. On the season, Eckhaus, 17 touchdown passes, only three interceptions. Not bad for a freshman. Tune into NEC Front Row on Saturday to see who ends the season on a high note, the freshman or the veteran. Bryant at Merrimack. Now to Brookville, Long Island, we go for the NEC featured game of the week on ESPN3. Trying to clinch their second outright NEC title in the last 7 months, Sacred Heart travels to LIU, and the recipe is simple for the Pioneers. Win and in. A victory over LIU guarantees Sacred Heart a trip to the FCS playoffs, and head coach Mark Nofri expects his veteran players will be up to the challenge.
They know what's at stake. They know what they have to do to prepare to win. They know what they have to do when they get to the game. They won't be nervous, I can tell you that. They'll be excited. I think the worrying part I have is that they'll be too excited. But they know what's at stake. And I think playing in the spring a big game like that, and what they've gone through their freshman sophomore year this past spring, and then have another opportunity this year, would be outstanding. And it kind of plays in our favor with the kids that I have and the leadership that they they've provided us throughout the 4 years or 5 years that they've been here.
Now, the experience with Sacred Heart starts in the trenches on both sides of the ball. The battle-tested Sacred Heart offensive line can run block with the best of them to make matters even tougher on LIU this Saturday. All-American running back Julius Chestnut is back in the fold, and he looked energetic in last week's win over Wagner. Chestnut gained 116 yards from scrimmage on 15 touches. And then don't forget about Malik Grant, the backup running back. Well, he's over 1,100 rush yards. Not bad for a backup. Now, when it comes to the SHU defense, we'll have more on them as a unit later in the show, but be sure to keep an eye on defensive end Kevin Pepra. He has 7 sacks this season, and Pepra will look to put the heat on LIU quarterback Camden Orth. The LIU signal caller has been sacked 26 times this season. He's thrown 10 touchdown passes to only 4 interceptions, and Orth and the Sharks hosting Sacred Heart. It's the NEC's featured game of the week on ESPN3. Kicks off at 12 noon. Paul Dottino, Kevin Gilbride, John Schmelk on the call live from Brookville. Now let's take a look at the NEC stock market. I'll tell you whose value is on the rise. And we're talking Central Connecticut senior receiver Tyshawn James. The 6'2" pass catcher had himself a day in week 11 at Duquesne. James, with 7 receptions for 169 yards in a touchdown in the 1-score setback. If you'll remember, he made an incredible catch down the stretch to put the Blue Devils into scoring position with only seconds remaining. And naturally, his performance made an impression on Duquesne head coach Jerry Schmidt.
He had the great receiver, and he had a couple big plays on us. He's a talented receiver. And after the game, I said, are you graduating? Are you sure? And he said, I am. I said, congratulations, you had a great career, and he's been a tough player to go against.
It's Tyshawn James. He leads Central Connecticut in receiving. He has a catch of at least 20 yards in length in 4 straight games. Big play James averages 15.3 yards per reception and 64.1 yards per game. Tyshawn James, his stock is on the way up. I'm calling the Twitter timeout, and to the tweet sheet we go. This one from Bryant running backs coach Ben McCaig. And as you can see, Ben had the privilege of coaching a productive unit up in Smithfield this year. As a team, the Bulldogs have scored a league-high 18 rushing touchdowns. Senior running back Daniel Adebaboye has 8 total touchdowns this fall, including 2 TD rushes in last week's win over LIU. As you can see, coach is grateful for his seniors, and he also included maybe the most important phrase that we'll see on the tweet sheet this week, and that is, let's finish. As coach says, Bryant will have a chance to finish win number 7 at Merrimack in week 12. You can catch it live on NEC Front Row. That's amazing. And it's all eyes on the Sacred Heart defense. Sacred Heart has not allowed more than 17 points during its current 5-game win streak. The Sacred Heart defense is amongst the national leaders in a number of team categories. Before we get to that, let's hear what head coach Mark Nofri had to say about his Pioneers defensive unit?
Well, they've been outstanding. You go back and you look at the four-game stretch that we've had, and you know, they pitched a shutout this past weekend. You go back to St. Francis, and they only gave up two field goals. The other 6-7 points was on a blocked punt. And then they gave up 13 to Duquesne, and, you know, they've been playing very, very well. And, you know, Coach Cook and the rest of the defensive staff has been putting them in great positions to succeed. And I think it goes back to how much the kids like playing football, how important it is to them. And they've been playing with that chip on their shoulder. You know, they play around, and we talk about being physical and playing our game and playing with emotion, and they've definitely been doing that. So it's great to see.
Limiting the opposition to only 261 yards per game, the Pioneers rank 7th overall in total defense amongst FCS team leaders. They're number 1 overall in pass defense. They're 14 points per game allowed. Well, that's the 6th best on the FCS charts. Sacred Heart, with a dominating defense, they have the numbers to prove it. The number 1 ranked pass defense in the football championship subdivision. And stats amazing. Well, I know it's week 12, and you're probably ready for the chop shop right about now. But unfortunately, Rick Saratella has fallen ill. He's unable to join us this week, but we wish him a speedy recovery. And as soon as he is better, we will reconnect with Rick and give you some NEC football updates from his NFL Draft Bible perspective. And of course, he's also a scout for the NFLPA Collegiate Bowl. You can go check out some of our previous chop shops on the archive. As for now, that's all I have for you. It's been a great season. Thank you for joining me for the ride. Enjoy week 12. I'll see you again sometime on the other side. I'm Ralph Ventry. Thank you for watching the whole nine yards on NEC Front Row.